Returns are a hassle for the parts store and the customer. They're even more frustrating for the counter pro when the part failed due to mistakes that were made during the installation process. Most water pump failures are caused by factors other than a faulty pump. In a previous video, we talked about how neglected coolant or the wrong kind of coolant can compromise the operation of a water pump. In this video, we're going to focus on some installation practices that can lead to premature water pump failure and some tips you can give your customers to get it right the first time. Specifically, we're going to look at how automotive sealant can make or break a water pump installation, depending on whether or not it's used correctly. And if the new pump comes with a seal, they need to make sure it's in pristine condition before installing it, as some seals are so thin they can be easily damaged when ripping off the packaging. However, if the water pump was supplied with an O-ring style gasket or a dry seal, they should resist the temptation to apply sealant because these seals don't need sealant. Most installation instructions advise that O-rings should be coated with coolant or oil to lubricate the seal and allow the two components to expand and contract independently. Likewise, if the replacement water pump comes with a carrier style gasket, they're not improving the seal by coating it with a sealant from a tube or a spray can. In fact, they could be causing problems by not allowing the gasket's lip to change shape to accommodate different rates of expansion. Also, the added substance might not be chemically compatible with the new gasket. If a carrier style gasket requires a sealant, some will include a portion in the kit. Most replacement gasket manufacturers will include instructions for installation that will outline whether or not sealants need to be applied. Here's the bottom line. Only apply sealant if the vehicle manufacturer recommends it, and don't use too much of it. Put a thin, even bead along the edge and around the coolant passages on the impeller side of the water pump, and wipe off the excess before mounting the pump. If your customer does this after they've mounted the water pump, they won't be able to see the excess sealant on the inside where it can damage the cooling system. Too much sealant can lead to misalignment of the pump once they start torquing the bolts, and the excess paste can clump together into chunks that contaminate the coolant and cause leakage or do serious damage to the thermostat. Another thing to keep in mind, sealants are made with different drying rates, so they need to respect the sealant's printed instructions. Improper use of sealants can contribute to premature failure of the water pump. Encouraging your customers to follow all instructions for sealants during installation can go a long way toward minimizing alleged defect returns. I'm Josh Cable. Thanks for watching.